Hello everyone. First of all, I welcome you all to this session where I will be taking or providing you a functional training on the sales, the purchase, as well as the accounting module. So I hope that I'm audible to everyone. So before moving on to the session, let me give you a quick intro about myself. So myself, Pooja Rigna, functional consultant at Cybrosis Technology. So as about Cybrosis Technology, we can say one of the leading ODO partner, which is having more than a decade of experience in ODO, both in community as well as the enterprise edition. And we have showcased many successful projects in ODO, that too in all the major business domain. So basically, the main agenda of today's training is to provide a functional training to all the end users as well as the public users in ODO. So this training would be based on ODO 14 enterprise version and mainly focusing on the modules like the sales and accounting. So let's move on to our training session for today. So here I have listed out benefits of ODO 14 sales, purchase and accounting module. So here you can see some of the features that I have listed for the sales management, that is sells more efficiently with the sales module of the ODO. We can say it reduces the data entry, provides us a professional quotation with the help of quotation builder, quotation template, and we also have the functionalities for upselling. Then also the functionalities where it helps to manage the orders as well as the contracts, where we have the different order specific as well as the options for changes from the sales order. Then also with the product as well as their prices, we have a wide varieties of features as well as the functionalities, which is dealing with the product variant, different product types, as well as the different product configurators that we can provide for the products and the coupons as well as the promotion program. Then with the discounts, then with the purchase management also, I have listed out some of the functionalities. Like the purchase tender agreement, call for tender agreement, and we also have the options where we can pairing on the purchase order, vendor bills, and so on. And regarding the request for quotation, similarly with the purchase management also, we have the automate the process functionalities, and the RFQs for your supplier can be created with the purchase module of our ODO. Then this, we also have the options for managing the incoming products as well as monitoring the RFQs as and its orders, and also the process where we handle the products with their locations as well as the show, defining the procurement rules for that and all. And similarly with accounting, like with the legal statements itself, the profit and loss, cash flow statements and all. So these are some of the functionalities we can say that we have listed with the accounting management. Now let's move on to our ODO dashboard. So here you can basically see the dashboard of my ODO where I have installed the module called the sales, accounting, purchase and inventory. So let's start our session. So first of all, we will be discussing about the functionalities or the features that we are having with the ODO. So as we know that ODO sales is one of the most important order management and minimum functionalities with the sales this module, it easily other opportunities and other options. So with Odo sales module, you have certain functionalities, like you have the orders menu, under which you have the options like quotations, orders, sales team, customers, and then two invoice options, where you have the options like order to invoice as well as order to upsell. Then you have the option called products, like product variant, products price list, promotion program, coupon program, and also a reporting section, and also have a session where dealing with the configurations and settings of the sales, and also have some additional functionalities like quotation template, shipping methods, attributes, as well as unit of measures, as well as category. So let's start with the first option, that is quotation. So here you can see, basically with Odoo 14, we can say that there is a lot of changes which is brought upon in the interface case. So the user interface in case of Odoo 14 has been lotly changed. That is, we are having here options like where we, from the tree view itself, we can see or we can schedule the activities. And here also you can simply chat with the concerned person by simply clicking on this icon of the particular salesperson. So it has been brought upon modified changes in case of Odoo 40. So here we get the options to create the quotation. So we can say that quotation is something that a supplier sends a list of product to its customer for accepting the orders. And when the quotation is accepted, then only the order is being made. So when you open this form of quotation, there you will get to see the form where you have the option to mention the customer name. So here, basically you can mention your customer. Then in this form itself, you will have the option like the quotation template. So with quotation template, we will look into the feature more detail afterwards, since we are having this option discussing this after explaining about this quotation. So with this particular customer, we have the options like the expiration date. So basically here you can mention the date of expiration for this particular quotation. You have this option over here. Then you have the option called as price list, which is shown over here. So basically you can see when I have selected this customer, automatically this price list as well as the payment term options were auto-filled. So basically for this customer, while creating the customer itself, we are having the options to provide this price list as well as the payment term. So basically we have provided that for particular customer. That's why when we selected this customer, default we get the price list as well as the payment term filled. So price list is nothing but it is a functionality which is used to manage the product prices. So basically with Odoo itself, we are having the two options of price list, like multiple prices per product as well as the advanced price list. So in detail, we will be looking at this price list functionality, because here we are having the options in the sales itself. And then we are having the option called as this payment term. So we can say that this payment term, or it regroups all the conditions under which a sale is completed and paid. They can be applied to a sale order, customer invoice, as well as for supplier bill also. So this is mainly used to ensure that they will be correctly paid on time. So here you can see when you take this customer external itself, you would be able to see that for this particular customer, you would have set this payment terms. Yeah. So you can see for this particular person, you have set this payment term. That's why you're getting that payment term over there. Okay. So then we are having the option over here, order line, where we are having the option product. So from here, what you can do is that you can simply add your product as per your needs. So here you can add your product. So when you open this, that is to add product, here you will get all your products that you have created. So from here, you can select any of your products and here you can similarly mention that particular product, and you can also provide and discount also. So this option basically enables here, because in the settings of the sales, we have enabled the option called as discount. So when you enable that option, it will help you to provide the discounts on the order line. So like that options we are having, then here we are also having an option to add a session. So basically this option is there is to differentiate between the products that you are adding into the order line. So suppose if you want to differentiate between the products, so suppose for now here I am adding some kind of service product. So in that case, what I can do is that I can add a session, and under this, what I can do is that afterwards I can add certain kinds of service product. So like that options we are having under this add section option. So for that we are having this functionality called as add session. And if you want to provide any kind of note in order to notify the customer for this, you can mention the note over here. So here you can simply provide any of the note over here. For that purpose, we are having the option called as add a note option over here. Then here in the other tab, we are having the option called as optional product. So basically with Odoo, we are having the functionality where we can mention the optional product. So it is all about that is a practice of selling an additional product, or we can say a service to the customer that are directly related to the item that is added to the order line. So here also, when you click on this, you would be able to add the product, which is either directly related to the product that you have added in this order line. So here we are having that option in optional product, so that in that tab we are have an option to add the optional product. Then in other info tab, we will be getting the option to mention the salesperson. So basically here you can mention the salesperson, that is the internal user who is in charge of them, and also the sales team also. Then you also have the options to mention the company. And also with Odoo, we are having the options for online signature as well as online payable. This option for this particular quotation, the customer would be able to provide or able to use the option of online signature as well. Here you have a kind of reference. So here reference in the sense, here you can provide any of the reference, which is basically identifying the particular customer only. So here you are having that options for providing that reference. Then here with the tag also, we can say we are having an option called as tag. So basically this tag can be considered as a keyword or a label that would help you to categorize your work, or we can say that it can be a useful source for filtering purpose. So here you can mention the tag and all. Then here you have the options under the invoicing for mentioning the physical position. So basically this physical position is something like, we can say that physical position are used to adapt the taxes as well as the account for particular customer or sale order or the invoices. So for that purpose we are using this physical position. So this functionality we will be in the editing module. So these are the some of the options that is while creating the quotation. When you come down here, you will have the options like the shipping policy. So here with Odoo, we are having the two shipping policy, that is as soon as possible or when all the products are ready. So this main functionality you can understand from the word meaning itself, that is when all the products are available. If you want to deliver that at that time, then you can select that when all the products are ready, or you can either use the option like as soon as possible. Then you have the option to mention the delivery date. So like this functionalities, or we can say the fields we are having with, while creating the quotation. Then with this quotation itself, you can see we are having the different stages of quotations, like quotations, quotation sent, as well as the sale order. So suppose if I use this option that is send by mail, so what this particular quotation would be sent to my this particular customer mail, and the state needs to quotation sent. Okay. So here I think there's some issue with the library. That's why I'm not able to use this option called as send by mail. Okay. So otherwise, when you click on this option that is send my mail, it would be in the option called as the quotation sent. And once you confirm this, what happened is that this quotations would be changed into sale order. So in this, when you confirm this particular order, you can say that here you will get a smart button where you can see one delivery is being done. And when you open this, here you will get a certain details about the delivery address of that particular person that you have chosen as a customer. And here the certain source document of the sale order that you have created and the corresponding product that you have added to the order line. And in the operation also, you will see the details like the product demand, how much is reserved and done. And the additional informations would be regarding the weight of that particular product. And if you are using any kind of carrier for shipping purpose, that would be shown over here. And if you want to need any kind or if you have provided any note, it would be shown over here. So once you validate this, you can see that the done quantity would be changed into one and the state changes to done state. And here you can see when you come back, you will get another option is then to create the invoice. So this is how we can say the quotation works with in case of Odoo. And in this quotation itself, you can see in the tree view itself, you can see the quotation that you have created and their status also. So here you will see the different status of your orders that you have done. So if it is confirmed or converted into sale order, the status would be based on sale order. And if it is still in a quotation, it will be shown in the quotation state. And here itself, in this view itself, you are having the different options where you can filter out your quotations. So when you do that, you will see all your quotations. And similarly, you can do with this. And with group, so you are having the different options where you can group by this with the customers as well as the salesperson also. You can see how much quotations as well as this one is done. So these are some of the options that we are having with the filters as well as the group by. And with this itself, you are having the different sets of view like list view, Kanban view. And here you will see the all other calendar pivot as well as graph view. And here you can also see the activities that is scheduled for each and every quotation. So within this quotation or while creating this activity and all, you can see that in that form itself, you will be having this option. That is when you come down, you will have options for sending the message or log note as well as to schedule the acting. So basically you can see that whatever you do with your quotations and all in the chatter, you will get an overview of thing that you have done to your quotations. It's created, it is showing over here. Then here from here itself, you will have the option to schedule an activity so that you can follow up to your customer. So for that purpose also, we are having the option over here. So here you can schedule an activity also. So that would be also be shown over here. And that is the planned activity also. And if you want to send any kind of message, you can similarly send your message from here. So these are some of the functionalities or features that we are having while doing this quotations. And similarly with the orders also, you will be seeing those orders that we have confirmed and the further orders that need to be create invoices and all. So in orders, you will also, in order to tree view, you will be seeing those status, like to invoice as well as nothing to invoice those sale orders, so which is confirmed, and the further procedures are remaining. So those orders you would be seeing under the sale order option. Now let's move on to the next phase, or the next menu is to invoice option. So in this to invoice, here you can see we have the option called as order to invoice. So let's open this. So in this, that is order to invoice, in this option you would be able to see those invoices which those orders for which yet the invoices are not created. So from here you would be able to list out all those orders which for which you have not yet created the invoice. So that this is only the basic need for this option, that is order to invoice, to view those orders which are not yet invoiced. And then we are having the option called as order to upsell. So we can say that with Odoo, Odoo supports the order to upsell option, that is when the delivered quantity comes greater than the invoice quantity. So basically, in Odoo, we are having an invoice policy. We can select the invoice policy that is based upon the ordered quantity or based upon the delivered quantity. So basically, we are having that option. In the settings also, where since the invoicing policy is like based upon ordered quantity or based upon the delivered quantity. So this order to upsell option comes under the invoicing policies of ordered quantity. So let me give you one example. So suppose if I can say that if a vendor got a sale order for 50 products for a company, so he create a quotation for that particular product, and that company confirm the particular sale order and then create an invoice for the same according to the ordered quantity. But at the number of product is 60, that is 10 more than the ordered quantity, then in that case the order to upsell is more than the invoiced quantity, that is it is applied to delivered quantity. So basically, here you can see I have already created one this. So here what I have done is that I have created an order. So here I have created an order as office lamp, and for this product called as office lamp, I mean the invoicing policies as based upon the ordered quantity. So office lamp, so here you can see that for my this product called as office lamp, I have provided the invoicing policies as the ordered quantity. Then what I have done is that basically I have created a sale order and I have mentioned my product as office lamp, and I have confirmed my sale order with the quantity called 50. But what I have done is that while delivering the product, I mentioned that the total done quantity is 60, that is 10 more than what is ordered by them. Then in that case, the order to upsell is, or this functionality works. So like this, those all create this itself, and when I click on this create invoice in sale order, in it is itself, you will be able to see this upselling opportunity. So those orders you would be able to see under order to upsell option. So here you can see you will get those orders where the quantity is 50 as well as the delivered one product is 60. So here what is doing is that we are upselling our product. So here we have the options with Odoo, like order to upsell, where we can upsell your product based upon the ordered quantity. Then this would be completely depending upon the customer, whether they want to accept that those 60 or to use the other 50. So those options is up to the customer whether they want to confirm it or not. So these options we are having are those orders we would be able to see in the option called as order to upsell, that is coming under the menu called as to invoice. Then the next option is regarding the products. So with products, here you would be able to see all the created products, and here itself you have the different views, like also have the list view and all, where you can see the other details like the product name, internal reference, and here also you will have the other features where you can enable this and you can simply see them in that particular tree view, or if you don't want, you can just disable that. So with product, we can say that Odoo has a striking product management that can be offered to any market that may fulfill the customer's specific wants or need. So here you have the options to create a new product. So basically here you are having the options to provide the product name. So the product name we can say is that it is the name which you will which will be displayed on all other screen that refer to the specific product that you would be creating. Then similarly, you would be having the option that is can be sold, can be purchased. So basically can be sold, that is to, we can say that to remove a product up from showing up on the sales product list, you can simply uncheck this option. Basically, we can say that it is used while creating a raw material or product for the internal consumption. So for that options, we are using the option called as can be sold and can be purchased. Then here you can see with product type, we are having the three options, that is consumable, service and storable product. So in case of Odoo, the everything that we are creating is marked as a product, but the difference would be coming in the product type. So here you have the product type like consumable. So consumable, we can mention a product type as consumable means those product for which we don't want or for which it does not affect any inventory. So those product we can mention as the consumable product, that the product does that does not affect the inventory. Then we have the service product type. So the service is something that you provide to your product. So for that, you can mention the product type as service for your product. And then you have the options to provide the storable product. So storable product, that it is, we can say that in this, we can maintain a minimum stock level for your product by defining the reordering rule and all. So as mentioned, the storable product is a kind of product type where we manage the stock for a product. So these are the three different product types that we are having with case of Odoo, that is consumable, service, as well as the storable product. Then we are having the product category option. So here what the user can organize the product under the specific category as per their need, they can create the category and all. And then here we are having option called as internal reference. So internal reference option is used to provide the code for your product, or we can say an alternative code which is help to understand or identify your product easily. For that purpose, we are using this internal reference. And then we are having the option called as barcode. So we know that generally when product is more, the probability of error increases. So to avoid that, we can update the product quantity by scanning the product barcode. So for that purpose, we have mentioned the function or the field called barcode over here. And then we have the options like the sales price, customer tax, cost, company, and then unit of measure, as well as the purchase unit of measure. So here, these are some of the options that you are getting under the options tab. And then you also have the option to mention any kind of internal note for this particular product. So when you select this product, it would be showing, if you provide any kind of internal note, it would be showing to that. When you select that product, it would be showing that. And then we have a variant tab under this product. So basically, when you enable the options of the variant in the settings of the sales module, you would be having this variant tab over here. So basically, here we can say the product variant are used to handle the product having different attributes like the color, size, brand, and all. So with attribute, we are having the separate menu where we can create the attributes and all. So that would be discussed later. And then we have the sales tab. So with sales tab itself, as I have discussed the case of invoicing, we have the two invoicing policy, that is whether the ordered quantity as well as the delivered quantity. So based upon that, the invoice would be created. And then also we are having an option called as optional product. So with optional product, as I told you, it is a process of selling an additional product or service with the product that you have directly related to the item that you have added in your order line and all. For that purpose, then also have a sales description. So this note would be added to the sale order as well as the invoices. So here you can provide that. And you also with the purchase tab, you have the options where you can mention the vendor name also. And then you also have the options with the reordering rules and with the vendor bills as well as the control policy that is based upon ordered quantity as well as the received quantity. So when it comes to purchase, it changed into received and order. And when it was with sale, it comes into ordered and delivered. And with inventory tab, you are having the options where you can see the sets of routes. So routes basically we can define as the path through which our product move internally. So for that purpose, we are having this route option. And then we have this logistic where we can mention the weight, volume, and other things related to the product. And similarly with this also, you have the options to provide the description for delivery, the orders, as well as the description at the times of receipt also. And with accounting, you would be having the options where you can mention this expense account as well as the income account. So those functionalities you would be having under this accounting tab of your module of the product. So from here, what you can do is that you can simply create your product and you are having these functionalities over here. Now let's move on to the next one, is with the product variant. So this product variant option, you would be able to see if you enable, as I told you, if you enable the options of variants in the settings of the sales module. So once you enable that only, you would be able to see that option. So in product variant option, you would be able to see all the products that are having corresponding attributes or the variants added to that. So suppose in product itself, if you take a product like, okay, customizable desk, so you can see that for this particular product in this variant tab, we would have added certain kind of attributes. So those attributes, since we have added, we would be able to see those products separately under this product variant tab, where you can see for this product aluminum is customizable desk based upon their attributes like length and color, it is differentiated into the different products. So here in product variant option, you would be able to see those kinds of product for which you have been added a corresponding attribute value. So as we are discussing about this product variant, let's discuss also about the attributes and how we are adding these attributes to a particular product. So before moving on to that, with the we are having the certain options in the settings that also add an account to this product. That is, first one is regarding this variant, and then we are having these two options called as product configurator as well as this variant grid entry. So basically these two options are some, it is these two functionalities we are able to see at the time of adding this product to the sale order. So let's see the functionalities with the variant. So when you enable this option variant itself, you will able to see the attributes from here, or otherwise you can also get the attributes from the here. So under this configuration also, you will able to get the attributes. So from here you can create the attribute. So basically, so we can say that for a particular product, we can provide a set of variants for that. So here you can provide the attribute name. So basically this field will provide a description of the attribute, such as the size, color, or brand option. So here we are having the different display type, that is radio. So whether you want to provide the display type as radio button and then select button, or as color, you are having this option over here. Then we are having an option called as the variant creation mode. So with this variant creation mode, we are having the three types, that is instantly, dynamically, and never. So when you use this option, that is instantly, so here all the possible combinations of variant would be created. That is as soon as the attribute value would be added to the product. So this is what we have seen for the customizable desk. We have added the attributes like legs as well as the color. So for that, the variant creation mode was instantly. So that's why when we provide a particular variant with the variant creation mode as instantly, what happens is that all the possible combinations of variants would be created as soon as the attribute value is added to the product. So here you can see the attributes that is already created, that is regarding the size and all. We can say, we can check the case with the legs itself. So here you can see the variant creation mode was instantly, and also with the color also you can see the mode is instantly. So with this, what happened is that when you add those attributes to the product, all the related combination of all the possible combinations would be created. Now suppose if I am creating a separate attribute and its variant creation mode as dynamically. So here like this, you can have the options to create and since I have selected this display mode as color, so I can choose the color for my attribute. And suppose if I am saving this, and with this itself, another set also I am creating is with the size. So here also I am selecting this variant creation mode as dynamically. So here I can mention the size also, saving this. So for right now, what I have done is that I have created two attributes, that is color one and size one, and keeping its variant creation mode as dynamically. So suppose if I'm going to my product and if I'm creating one of my product called as shirt, and I'm mentioning the product type as storable product, and then in the variant option here I'm adding my products. So with here, suppose if I'm adding my product like color one, so here I would be able to choose the values of my, and then here I'm adding the size two. Here I'm sorry, the size one was something that we have created with the creation mode or the type variant type as dynamically, and let me provide the name as shirt one. So if I am saving this, so you can see that when I save this, I didn't get the options or didn't get a smart button over here where I can see this variant variant. So suppose if I am creating another product with shirt, and for this product itself, product mentioning the color. So for this color that we have created, the variant creation mode is instantly, okay. And here if I'm adding the size also, you can see it's here I will get a smart button called as four variant. So this is the difference that I was telling you. If the variant creation mode is instantly, automatically all the possible combinations of the variant would be created, whereas if it is the case with the dynamic, so if the variant creation mode is dynamic, so here the variants are created dynamically, that is only when the attributes are added to the order line, then only you would be able to see this variant that you have provided for this product. Then with that itself, we are having this options when you come down is regarding the sales variant selection. So this was something that we have seen in the settings of the sales, that is product configurator as well as the variant grid entry. So when you enable this option called as the product configurator and you are using a product or a shirt whose variant creation mode we have created or we have selected as dynamically. So here you can see for the shirt one, you will see a certain kind of pop-up where they will ask you to configure your product. So this is the view that you will get if your type product configurator type, if you select this view type as product configurator, so where you can see the color and all. And as I told you, since for this shirt one product, I have set the variant creation mode as dynamically. So here only the attribute would be displayed when I add this to order line. And from here I can select as well as also add the quantity. So this is the case if you are looking with the type of the product as product configurator. And with this itself, you are having the other options like the variant grid entry under the variant. So here, the variant selection mode, if I make it as order grid entry, then you can see the corresponding changes you will get in the view while using this product. So if, suppose if I'm adding this product, so like this. So here it will provide you a grid view where you from where you can select your variant. So this is the basic difference that you are getting with this product, that product variations. So here you can see your variant. Yeah, for here you can see the product with different variant. So this is the basic difference that we would be seeing for product also. So you can see for this product itself, there would be some additional informations that for the product that we are having the variant. So suppose if I take this shirt, so you can see for this shirt, there is four variant. So when you open this itself, you will have the option to mention the sales price, cost price, and here you can see the cost and price of this. And other option you can see is that you will have the option to configure the variant. So when you select that, you will also get an option to add an extra price to the variant also. So from here you can add the extra value price to the product. So that option is also available. So likewisely, you can also add the extra price to your different attributes that you are using. So that options we are having under this product variant as well as the product. Then the next option is with the price list. So in order to get this option of price list over here, you have to enable the option in the settings of the sales. So here you have the option called as price list, where you can use price list for your product. So here you also have, you can see you will have the option called discount. So when you enable this option only, you would be having the functionalities or the availability to add the discounts on the sale order line. So if you enable that, you will get that functionality. And here you have the option called as price list. So basically, with price list, if we are looking, we can say that price list are nothing but a list of prices of product, that is, we can say that is the product on sale. So using this price list feature, one can easily manage the product prices for specific depending upon the company need and all. And with price list itself, we are having the two options, that is for multiple prices per product as well as the advanced prices per product. So here we are having these two options. So let's have a look over this option. So with this option, we can say that suppose for multiple prices for product, I can use this option called as price list. So here you will get an option to create a price list. So with multiple prices per product, here you can create a price list for customer segment also and for different prices for different currencies also. So if you enable the option called as multiple currencies in the general settings, you would be able to select the currencies also from here. So here you can provide the name of the price list that you can create. So here you can also mention the company, and here you can see in this product you would be able, in this line you would be able to add those product. So from here you can simply add your products to the price list, and with this itself you can mention the variant also for this particular product. So suppose if I am choosing my product like shirt, so for that corresponding variant also, means if for certain variant products I want to set this, I can use this option called as variant. And here I can mention the minimum quantity. So suppose if I mention the minimum quantity as some 100, and so suppose, let me, okay, provide this minimum quantity as 10, and here I can mention the price as 1000. So suppose if any of my customer create a price list for this price list over here by adding certain conditions, like where I add the shirt and mention the minimum quantity and prices, and here I can also mention the start date and end date, which will specify the validity of this particular price list over here. So I can use that options too. Otherwise, what I can do is that I can just create this price list. So what happens is that while creating a particular sale order, you have seen that we, in creating a sale order itself, you will have an option where you can add the price list. You can have the options to select the price list. So if you select this price list, so suppose if a particular customer uses this price list and purchases a minimum quantity of 10 shirt, what happens is that automatically the price would be updated to 1000. So we are having the option called as price list. So that is multiple prices per product. That is, we can create a multiple prices for product and can be used for different currency as well as for customers also. And here we are also having the option where we can mention this country group and also the discounts, whether the discounts that we are adding should be shown separately or should be included in the price, or should we have to show that means separately, or should it be included in the price of the product also. So that option you are having over here. So once you created that as per your conditions, you can save that. So here you can see automatically means the already created one, the price list. So here you can add similarly the different conditions as per your need. And the other options for price list is with the advanced price rule, where you have this discount formulas and all. And when you enable this option, so basically this advanced price rule, we can say that here we, with this, we are able to set certain kinds of rules based upon the product cost, or we can say the public prices and certain other options. So here you can see when I make that change here itself, you can see earlier when the option was, that is the multiple prices per product, I was having the option over here, or the here I was having the option called as product. Now you can see here I am getting an option called as applicable on. And when I click on this, here I would be able to see, or I will get a pop-up where I will able to have these options. That is on the basis like the price list or the price rule that I am creating, whether it should be applicable to all the products or to particular set of product category also I can do that. And to particular single product or product variant also I have the option to mention. And similarly, if I want to mention the created price list or these conditions to be applied to all the product, I have to select the option called as all product. Then here I have the option to mention the minimum quantity as well as the starting date, and the end date option also I am getting over here. And with computation also I am having the certain options over here, that is whether the fixed price percentage and formula. If it is fixed price, you will get an option to add the fixed price over here. And if you mention the percentage here, you can mention the percentage also. And when you click on this particular formula, you will get a certain additional fields also, where the new price of your product would be calculated on the based upon the sales price that you provide for your product, and also the discounts that you are deciding or that you are looking forward to provide. With that also a surcharge and discounts would be also added. So here you can add some additional, or here this is what we are calling as surcharge, and also a rounding for the pricing also can be provided. And with that itself you can also mention the minimum margin as well as the maximum margin for the particular rules that you are setting in, so that you can create that on the basis of the type or the rule or the price list we can say that you are thinking to create. So here you can mention the all the margins, or we can say basically these options of minimum margin and maximum margins are to ensure the minimum profit as well as the maximum profit and all. And with this public prices also you will get an option. So basically the formula will be calculated on the basis of the sales price of the product. So if you are making this formula, we will get some additional options where you can add this price discount, surcharge, as well as mention the minimum margin as well as the maximum margin for that particular product. So those functionalities also you will get together while creating this price list, or we can say when you will use this option called as advanced price rules. So like that you can create and the create the price list as per your need. And also in the configuration you would be having the option to mention this country group as well as the discount policies. So that is all about the price list. So basically price list option is a feature with which we can easily manage the product prices. Then we are having the option called as promotion and coupon program. So that also you have to enable from the settings of the sales module. So once you enable this coupon program and promotion program from here, then only you would be able to see that option over this product menu. So with Odoo, it provides a promotion as well as program as a marketing tool in the sales module. So we can say that the sales promotion program as well as the coupon program are like a short terms of incentive itself, we can say that, with which it can drive the customer towards the company's product and services. That is like providing coupon prices as well as the product samples, etc. So here we are having those options. So let's check the options that are. So likewise, what you can do is that, so from here you can create a new promotion program, where basically here you can provide the name of the promotion program, or here you can provide, that is suppose buy one get one free, like that name you can provide over here. So that program would be, so the name here would be the reference for you to understand the promotion program that you are creating. Then here you are having the certain conditions which helps you to filter out your records. So here either you can do that, you can edit the domain and you can put some condition. So suppose if you want to filter out your customers, or if you want to provide this promotion program a set of or specific group of customers, then you have the options to filter out. And also you can filter out the product also similarly. You will have the options over here. Then here you will have the option to mention the quantity. So at how much minimum quantity, that means at what quantity you will provide this promotion or this particular coupon program. So minimum required product quantity to enable this program. And also you will have the option to mention the minimum purchase of. So here you can mention the minimum amount. So if a customer makes a minimum purchase of this amount, then only if you want to make this promotion program enable, you will have the option to provide the minimum purchase of over here. Then you will have an option to mention the promo code usage. So basically with this promo code usage, we are having the two options, that is either to apply automatically or use a code. So when you use this option, that is automatically apply, what happens is that, so if your customer make a sale, and if he satisfy the corresponding conditions or the minimum quantity, minimum purchase amount you are providing over here, if he set and if he click on this option, that is to provide the promotion, what happens is that in the order line of the sale, it would be automatically added. Or if you use this option, use a code, here you would be having the options to provide the promotion code to the corresponding promotion program that you are creating. So only after enabling or after mentioning this promotion code, that promo code would be added to the order line. So that option we are having over here, that is automatically apply, as well as use code. Then here with the validity also, we are having the certain options to apply, whether it for here you can mention for how much orders if you applied, and if you mention it zero for or infinite use, you can use this promotion program. Then here you can mention the validity, that is with the start date and end date too. You will have the options to mention over here. Then here, when you come down, you will see the option with the rewards. So with rewards, you will be having an option where you can see the applicability, whether you want to apply this promotion or this coupon program on current orders, or whether you want to apply on the next incoming orders. If you want to do that, you can use this option like send a coupon. Then with the rewards, you have the option whether you want to have a discount. So if discount, we can say the promotion program, that is 20% off and all. Then free product, if you are doing, we can say that buy one get one free. So in that case, you can provide that free product over here, mention that product. And if you are providing this free shipping, what you can do is that you can use this option called as free shipping. So this is how we can say you can create this promotion program over here. So it is as simple as you can see, where you can set your conditions and add these things to your sale order. And suppose same with the coupon program also. Here also you can mention your coupon program. So suppose if I mention like the 20% discount on some kind of product, I can mention that. And here I can mention certain conditions, and based upon, as I told you, you can filter it out. You can mention the quantity too. And here if I'm mentioning the minimum purchase of some 500 rupees, and if I say the minimum quantity is one only, I am providing a discount. That is, since my coupon promotion program is 20% discount, so here I will be mentioning my percent as 20%. And here I have the options to mention, that is on an order or cheapest product or specific product and all. So if you mention the specific product, you will have the option to mention that specific product. So besides that, if I'm using this and saving this, and here I will get an option to generate the coupon. So once I click this, they will ask me whether to generate, that is the generation type, the number of coupons or number of selected customer. So if I use this number of selected customer, here also I will have the options to add filters. So when I add filter as per my name to only those customers, this would be generating this coupon, or otherwise I can mention my coupon over here. So here I can mention the number of coupons that I want to generate this number. So suppose if I am copying this number, okay. Now let's go to sale order, or let's create one sale order. So here I can mention my customer name, and suppose if I'm choosing one of my product, okay. So here if I am, okay, I'm adding this product, and if I'm mentioning the sales price as 200, okay. So here you can see that when I enable this option, that is promotion coupon program, then only I will get the option of where I can see this button coupon and promotion. So suppose for this product, that is 5 quantities and unit of measure, I have provided 10. So let's take one quantity and let's make this unit of measure as some 600. Okay. So when I click on this coupon program, so they will ask me the coupon code. So here I can generally paste the coupon code, and if it satisfies the current coupon or the program that we have created, and when you click on this apply, so if it satisfies, it would be added to this, and if it does not, it would not be added. So you can see that this conditions is added. Means the coupon program or the coupon code that we have created satisfy the above condition of quantity as well as the unit price. So it would be applicable for this product. So that's why you can see that it would be added over here. So this is how we can say this coupon code as well as the promotion program works with this. And if you make the corresponding sale order for that and all, you can see that one sale, and you would be see that is once it is used, it will the state of the corresponding code that you have used would be shown as used state. So this is how we can say the promotion program as well as the coupon program works. So with Odo, this promotion and coupon programs are the marketing tool that we are having in our sales module. Then we are having the options called as sales team. So in here itself, that is under this order menu, we are having the option called as the sales team as well as the customer. So basically with this sales team here, you will basically see the pipeline of the sales team or the pipeline management of the sales team that you have created. And here you will be having the options to create the sales team. So from here, basically you can create your sales team. Here you can see the already created sales team over here. So basically in the sales team option, creating sales team, you will be having the options to mention the sale lead. I mean, you will have the options to mention the team leader and team leader company, and also the options to mention the invoicing target. And here you can add your team members. So creating a sales team is very easy, and that corresponding sales team pipeline management you would be seeing over here, and these are the invoicing target that you would be seeing over here. And with this sales team itself, you will be able to see the those orders or quotations that is under that particular sales team, assigned to that particular sales team from this pipeline management regarding the orders also, as well as those orders whose invoice need to be created and all. So those options you would be able to see here. And then we are having the options with the customers. So from here you can create your customers. So basically right now you can see the already created customer, or within the customer tab you would be having the options. You can see the options to mention whether it is a corresponding individual person or a company. So if it is an individual person, you will get the option to mention the company to over here. Then here you can mention the name of that particular person and the corresponding company addresses and regarding the tax ID. and also the job position, phone, mobile, email number. So all other details of that particular persons can be added over here. Then here you have the different tabs with contact and addresses. So basically here you can add or you can add the contact address of this particular person. So here you can see that with Odoo we are having the different addresses. So if it is a basic contact, you can mention the contact, contact name and all, and other details like title, job position and all. And also we also have the options to mention the invoice addresses as well as the delivery addresses. So basically here you can also provide the two separate different addresses, and if there is any kind of other address or private address, that can also be mentioned with this particular person while creating this contact address. So you are having that options over here. Then with this sales and purchase, you are having the options for mentioning the salesperson. So as I told you, you will have the options where you can, here you can basically mention the salesperson, that is the internal user who is in charge of this. And here you can mention the delivery method. So these are basically the shipping methods that would be used for this particular persons. So basically this delivery, if you mention that, it would be added to the order line. And here you will mention this payment term. So as discussed earlier, this payment terms can be certain kind of conditions to make sure that the customer correctly pay on time and all for that. And similarly with the price list also, as I told you, while discussing the price list, we will have the options to mention the created prices for the customer. So if you provide the price list option over here, and when you select this customer, automatically the field would be filled. And then with the physical position also, and similarly for the purchase center also, we are having this payment terms, payment method and all. And then in the accounting also, we would be having this account receivable and the options to mention this bank account and all, and account receivable and account payable. So basically this receivable account, we can say, is the account where we add what our customers owe us. That is when you sell certain amount of product, the money that you have to receive will fitting over this account. And similarly, you have this account payable. So this is for vendors. That is when you purchase a product, the money you have to pay or will affect this account. So this is for that account. And then you having an options to provide internal. So if you want to provide any kind of internal note for this particular customer, you can use that. And you can see, as I told you, whatever you do in Odoo, whatever contact, anything you do, that corresponding thing would be shown in the chatter box. So these are some of the things that is we are having, or the options that we are having with this customer details here, or while creating the customers. And then, so this is about this customers. And as we have discussed about the sales team, so the sales team pipeline management, you can see from here, and you can create the sales team from here. Then we are having the option called as quotation template. So we can say that this quotation template is used to make quotation for more than one product. So suppose if I make this quotation like furniture, and here I can mention the quotation expiry days, after how much days this particular template would be expiring. Here I can mention the company too. And here I can add the product also. So suppose if I am adding my product over here, large cabinet, large desk, and large meeting table. And here I'm mentioning the quantity too also, and I'm saving this. So basically, when the purpose of creating this quotation template, we can say that suppose if your customer is frequently purchasing the same quantity, that we can make a custom quotation layer. So for that purpose, we are using this quotation template. For time consuming, so what So basically what we do with quotation template is that if a customer is frequently buying some kind of product, we can create them as a template. So what happens or what will happen is that if you save this and when you go for creating a quotation and when you click on this create button, or suppose if I select this particular customer and if I mention this quotation template that I have created, automatically those product would be added in this order line. That is, we don't need to add it manually. So if a particular customer is frequently buying the same quantity and same product quantity and all, what we can do this, we can simply create a quotation template. So that would be much easier instead of adding that manually to the order line. So for that purpose, we are having this option called as quotation template. Then we are having the option called as tag. So this tag option, we can say, as I told you, that it basically act as a keyword or the label that help you to categorize your work. So here you can simply create your tag, or we can say a useful source for filtering purpose also. So here also what you can do is that here you will have the options to select the different sets of color. You can also set different sets of color also. You would be having this option over here. So basically with tag, we can say it is a kind of label that will help you to categorize your work. So for that purpose, we are having the option called as tag over here. And then we are having the option called as shipping method. So this shipping method options also we are getting if you are enabling the options in the settings called as, here you can see we will have the option called as delivery method. So basically it is used for computing the shipping cost that we are getting on the orders. So for that purpose, we are having the shipping methods. So here you can see we can also, that is shipping method. So using this, we can manage the transport of the company, the price as well as the destination. And you can also integrate the Odoo with the external shipping connectors to compute the real price and the packing. So these are some of the external shipping connectors like UPS connector, FedEx, BP Post. So once you enable this also, you can configure the shipping method correspondingly. So right now I have enabled this option called as delivery method over here. So here, let's save this. And when I use the shipping method, I would be able to manage the shipping cost. So here I will see the shipping method. So here you can create a shipping method. So basically here you can provide the name that will signify the method that you have created. And here you will have the options to mention the providers, that is fixed price or based upon route. So suppose if we use this fixed price, you will have the option to mention the fixed price over here. That is for corresponding delivery charge. Here you can mention. So for that, you can mention the product also over here. And for that particular So I hope that now you can see my screen, and I hope that my voice is also audible to you. So yeah, we were discussing about this shipping method. So as discussed that which shipping method you would be having the options to create the shipping method based upon the different providers like the fixed price and based upon separate rules. So here you will see the option to see that. And with this itself, you can see that when you enable this option called as fixed price, here you will get the option to see or the provide the option to provide the fixed amount. So likewise, you can do that. And here also with you have the other tab called destination availability. So with this destination availability, here you will be having the option where you can mention the country, state, zip from and zip to. So basically here you can provide a certain kind of conditions or by filling this form, it will allow you to filter this delivery carriers or the shipping methods you are using according to the delivery address of the customer. So for that purpose, you are using this options called as this mentioning this destination availability tab. Or also here you can see we have an option that is free if the order amount is above certain amount. So when you enable or when you check this option, you will have the options to mention the amount over here. So suppose if a customer makes a certain kind of means if we make a purchase of a certain huge amount, what we can do is that we can mention the delivery charge as free. So for that purpose, we are having the option called as here, that is to free the amount, we are having the option. Then here also we are having the option called as install certain providers. So this was some additional thing that I told you that with shipping methods with Odoo, we can integrate the other external shippers like UPS, DHL and all. So when you enable this option or when you use this option, you will be having the provisions for using their functionalities also. So these are some of the shipping methods. So suppose here, suppose if I use this normal delivery charge option and here I can mention, suppose if I mention that if my amount goes above 1000, I can mention that this normal delivery charge is free, that is no certain amount is added. And now when I take an order, so here I will get an option. So the thing is that with case of Odoo, when you enable this option, you will get the shipping as well as coupon and promotion program also. So you can simply add your product over here. And suppose if I confirm this also, and if I mention this unit product is about something, if I mention it is 2000, and if I say if I buy this 7 quantity, so the amount is here this. So here I will have the options to add the shipping. So for that, suppose you, so if I add this option that is add shipping here, it will show that different shipping methods we would be able to select from here. And from here itself, you can see a pop-up comes. That is the shipping is free since the order amount exceeds the 1000. So this is how we can say that the shipping method in Odoo works with. So this is about the shipping method that we are having with Odoo. Then with the attributes we have discussed, the next thing coming is regarding the unit of measures. So with when you enable this unit of measures from the settings of the sales, you will have the functionalities called as unit of measure as well as unit of measure category. So while handling with this business process, we know that it is very essential that is to sell as well as buy products in different quantity that are convenient for consuming purpose. So here itself we are having two options when you enable, that is unit of category and unit of measure. So unit of category refers to under which categories those units are coming. So here you will having only the options to mention the category name only. So here you can mention the category those under which this particular unit of measure comes. And here you have the option called as unit of measure. So it refers to which all units the products are sold and purchased. So here you can basically mention the unit of measure, can mention the category, and basically here you also have different types, that is whether it is the reference unit or it is higher than or the smaller than the reference unit. So these options we are having with the unit of measures. So with the sales module, if you are looking, we are having the certain functionalities like this unit of measures, coupon and promotion programs. And with this also, we are having this online signature, online payment option also, and shipping. We also have this delivery methods and different shipping connectors options. Now let's move on to the next module, that is our purchase module. So as we know that purchase is basically the act of buying products, services, or raw materials, or we can say some extra parts from the providers for our business needs. So when you open this purchase module itself, you will see options like orders, products, reporting, as well as the configurations. So products, we will have this request for quotations, purchase order, purchase agreement, and vendor. And with ODO 14, we can say the new functionalities or the new feature that is brought up in the purchase module is with this dashboard view, that we from where you can see the all RFQs, my RFQs option, to send waiting state, lead options, and all. So these are some of the basic, or we can say the new functionality added to ODO 14 purchase module. So from here, basically you can create a quotations where you can mention the vendor name. So basically here you can mention the vendor name, and you can mention certain kind of reference that could be easily useful for identification. You can mention that, and here you can add your product. So basically here you can add your product that you want to purchase it from your vendor. So you have this option also. And with description, or sorry, with the other information tab, you will have the option where you can mention the purchase representative, the company options, and other payment terms and physical portions. So as I told you, we will have this payment terms for both the sales and purchase module also. So here you can mention that, and you can also mention the order deadline for this particular quotations. And similarly with request for quotation also, you are having the three different states, that is the RFQ, RFQ sent, as well as the purchase order. So once you create this RFQ, or once you create this quotation, we can move them into different stages. So once you create a quotation and RFQ, and you use this option like send by mail, it moves into the state called as RFQ sent. And once you confirm this order, automatically it would be converted into the state called as purchase order. So this is the simple thing that we can do. So here, let me give you a quick how it works. So suppose if I save this and confirm this order, automatically here you can see a receipt. So you will get an option to receive this. So once you validate this, it will change into the state called done state. And then with this, you will have an option to create the bill for corresponding quotation. So this is how the workflow, that is from request to quotations to the purchase, or the purchase order, goes like this. Then with purchase, we also have the option called as purchase order, where similarly you can see those purchase confirmed orders, but still regarding the invoices that are not, or regarding the bill that has not yet been created. Then you also have the option called as purchase agreement. So to view this purchase agreement option, you have to enable the option called as the purchase agreement in the settings of the purchase module. So once you enable this, you will get this option. So basically this purchase agreement, we can say, is a form of contract that points out the term or certain conditions for selling the product, that is between the sellers as well as buyer. So it contains the cost of product and will assist in a smooth scale for the product. So we can say that when you enable this, you will get this option called as purchase agreement option over here to create. Also in this configuration part here, you can see the purchase agreement type. So basically with ODO by default, we are having these two agreement types called as call for tender as well as the blanket order. So basically we can say this call for tender is a kind of agreement type where this multiple RFQs can be generated as multiple tenders to different vendors, so that the convenient RFQ can be confirmed and others can be cancelled. So here itself, you will be having certain options like this agreement type, then agreement selection type. So in agreement selection also, you will have this select only one RFQ. So when you do that, that is when a purchase order is confirmed, the remaining RFQ will be cancelled. And here also have an option to select multiple RFQ. So in this, when you use this option called select multiple, it won't cancel the other RFQ upon confirmations of a single RFQ. And then have this line, use line of agreement and all. So it would be automatically added the product to the product line and the RFQ that is generated. And for setting the quantity manually, you will have this options that is use quantities of agreement and all. And suppose if I'm saving this, and here in the purchase agreement, I will have the options to create. So here, basically what I can do is that here I will have the options to mention this purchase options to mention this purchase representative. Here I can mention this, which agreement type I used to. Here I can mention the agreement type also. And here I can add the other details like agreement deadline, ordering date, delivery date, other details like that. And suppose if I'm mentioning here and also mentioning the price called as, if I'm mentioning the price as 100, and suppose if I save and confirm this, here I can add new quotation where I can see I can add the vendor name. Suppose here I add the vendor name, and here for this particular vendor, if I am changing the unit price, I can save this. And if I use this option called as send by email, so automatically the state would change to RFQ send. So right now I'm having a certain issue with the library. That's why I'm not able to do that. And when I do that also, the state would change to RFQ send. And when I again click on the create option, I will get an option to select the other vendor. So likewisely, what happens is that in the purchase or in this RFQ, I would be having this multiple RFQ, or I will be having the options to select this RFQs. So as per my convenient, means as per seeing the vendor as well as the amount that they're selling, I can choose this. So for that purpose, we are having this call for tender option. And the next option that we are having with this purchase agreement type is the blanket order. So basically, blanket order is nothing but it is mainly used in case where a bulk amount are purchased in a specific period of time. So for that, we are using these agreement types. So here, similarly, you can create a purchase order, or you can send an RFQ to that corresponding vendor and all. So for, we can say for recurring purchase order, we can say we will be using this blanket order agreement type. So with this agreement type itself, here you are having the different options or the fields to make sure that if you want to add that corresponding amount automatically to the order line and all. So for that, we are having the option called as this purchase agreement, I mean sell multiple quantity and use this and all. Then we are having the options with vendor. So as discussed, in case of customers also, we are having the same options and same fields for the vendors also, where we can mention the details and all. So we are also having the same fields over here while creating the vendor too. Then with the product, we are having the option called as product as well as product variant. So from here also, you can view all your products and all. And then when you come to configuration, you are having an options for setting the price list. So as I told you, price list is an option where you can set prices for different product as per your customers as well as the vendors also. So price list can be, means we can also set the price list based upon this product and all. So for vendors also, you can set your price list. So the main need is that you have to provide the vendor name over here. And also you can mention the product name, product code also. And here you can see with the price list option, you will have the option to mention the product, its quantity, unit price, as well as the validity option. So as you have seen that by creating a product itself, inside the product purchase tab, you have the option to mention the vendor too, where you can use this options too. And with vendors also, you are having the functionalities of adding this vendor price list. And then in the settings of the purchase module, you can see we are having an option called as purchase order approval. So basically this option is means used to request the manager to approve a certain orders if it goes above this minimum amount. So basically if your employee is making a purchase of certain product which goes above this minimum amount called 5,000, so automatically what happens is that a request would be sent to the manager that once he approved that only, the further process, the other employee can work on that. So for that, we are having this option called as purchase order approval, which will request the manager to approve the order if it is above certain minimum amount. So for that purpose, we are having this purchase order approval. And then we are having this product attributes. So as discussed earlier, we have seen this in the cases of the sales module also, that is the attributes. So this is the same as that of we have discussed in case of the sales, that is regarding the attributes, the variant creation mode and all. And then we are having the option called as the product category. So here we are having the options to create the product category. So here you can create the product category as per the your needs. So here you can mention the name of your category, and here you can also mention the parent category if any. You can also do that over here, and here with this itself you can see we are having the also options for mentioning the force removal strategies, that is the first in first out and other thing. And we are also having the options over here which mentions this called the inventory valuation. So with inventory valuation itself, we are having a different sets of costing methods and all, that is the standard costing method FIFO as well as the average costing method and all. So this is the different costing method that we are using over here. And then we are having this inventory valuation, that is manual and automated. So if you are using inventory valuation as manual, so the accounting entries, that is to value the inventory, are posted automatic, are not posted automatically when the product either enters or leave the company. And then if you make this automated, what happens is that the accounting entries would be automatically created to a value the inventory, that is when the product enters or leaves the company. Then we are having this income account and expense account to certain other options also. So this is with the product category that we are having. And then we are having the unit of measures as well as unit of measure categories that we have discussed similarly in the case of sales module. And then in the settings, we would be having an option called as three-way matching. So basically, we can say that three-way matching is a functionality that helps to determine the validity of the vendor bill. That is to determine whether it should be paid or not. So it also means it also prevents the customers from paying a fake vendor bill. So when you enable this option itself, by default, there is three default options, that is yes, no, as well as the exception case. So the yes option will come, that is you have to pay the bill since you received the quantity of product, and no means don't pay the bill because you have not yet received the product. And exception arises, that is if there is any kind of differences in the ordered quantity billed as well as the received quantity for product. So these are some of the three cases that you will come. So here you can, when you enable this and when you create this product itself, I mean you, when you create this purchase product, purchase order, make sure that the billing control policy should be of the particular product should be on the received quantity. So basically three-way matching is a way which makes sure that you have to pay the bill only for the product that you receive. So make sure for the product you make the receive billing policies as received quantity, and likewisely you would be able to see the different changes over here. So this is about the configuration or the settings of the purchase module. Then if you are looking into the reporting also, you can see a purchase analysis based upon different measures. Here you can have the different measures over here and different group by options based upon the order date, orders, confirmations date and all, and different graph views as well as, and you can also able to see the different pivot view where you can make the different orders based upon different orders as well as based upon the product. So this is the wide reporting section that you are having with the purchase module. So this is, we can say in nutshell, this is all the features or the functionalities that we are having with our purchase module. Now let's move on to the accounting module. So we know that the Odoo platform provides the user with an effective as well as a reliable accounting dashboard that deals with the accounting aspects of the company. So in the dashboard itself, you will have the options or an options to start, or you can add your bank account from here itself. So when you click on this also, you will have the options to add your bank account or also to create them also. And you can also configure your accounting period also. So from here itself, that is from the dashboard itself, you will have the option to mention your accounting period also, like opening date, then the fiscal year end options, periodicity, reminder and all, and also have the option to mention the journal. And from here itself, you can also review the chart of accounts. You can also create the chart of accounts and can also mention the opening and closing opening balance to certain of the accounts also from the dashboard itself. So as said you that with accounting dashboard, it provides a reliable method of setting out. And in the dashboard itself, you can see the certain journals that is already there with the accounting module. So here you would be able to see the journals and other related informations that that is going on with the separate journals. Now let's move on to the next tab called customers. So here you can really compare that. Here you have the option called as customers and vendors. So here you can make a comparison between them two, that for customers we are having the invoices, for vendors we are having the bills. Similarly, for credit note, refunds, we are having the options, and customers, here we are having the vendors. So let's have a look on it one by one. So first one is to create the invoices. So basically in accounting also, you are having the option to see the invoices. So here you can see all the invoices created automatically and its status also. So if you want to create the invoice, you can also create the invoices from the here also, where you can select your customer from here, can mention the invoice date to, and can mention the product to this particular order line. So here you can mention your product to the order line and the corresponding invoices also you can make. And once you confirm this, you can see that it would be going into the state called as the postage state. And other options you would be getting over here is to make the register payment. So before moving to that, here you will see the journal items that is related to this. So this product sale and all options is something that we are providing inside the product category of the product. So those things would be coming over here, and then we are really having the options to mention this register payment. So here you can select the journal, and here also you can mention the receipt bank account. Here you will see the options to amount, payment date and memo also, and you can simply click on the options to create the payment. So once the payment is done, it would be showing as in payment. And here you will see in the invoice line, you can see the amount due also, options you can see over here. So basically with this customer invoice or with the vendor also, with this bill option as well as with this invoice, here you can see all the invoices which are created, and it's based upon the status also, you would be able to see that. So these are the basic thing that comes with invoice. Then we are having the option called as credit note. So basically, we can say that credit note can be a kind of document that is issued to a customer that notifies them that they have been credited a certain amount. So suppose that is while creating the invoice itself, you can see that while creating this invoice itself, I have an options to add a credit note. So it is a kind of document that is issued to a customer that notifies them that they have been created to certain amount. I mean, suppose we can say like if there kind of there is mistake in the invoice, or if they want to return the goods, or the goods, if the goods that they are delivered are damaged. So for that purpose, we are using this. So here you will have this option. So for that purpose, we are having this credit note. So suppose if I create this credit note, I can add the customer over here, and I can, what I can do is that I can also add the product and all, and I can mention this invoice date. So what we can do that, we can separately create that from this credit note option. Or other thing, what we can do is that we can just use from here. That from here also, if the payment is done, we will have the options to mark the credit payment. Credit note. So with credit note itself, we are having the three options. That is the partial refund, full refund and full refund and new credit invoice. So this partial refund, you can choose them options to do the partial refund, or if you want to modify the details of credit note like that. And if you want a full kind of refund, you can use this full refund option. So here the ODO will create a credit note automatically and validate it as well as reconcile the original invoice with that also. Whereas with this case, a draft invoice would be also created, and you can also mention the reason why you want to return that product. So for that, we are using this credit note option over here. Then here we are having the option to mention the payment. So here you can see, we can see all the payment done. So to view that also, you can have the option called payment over here. So here you can see we would have this payment type as well as here. With this also, payment partner type also you can mention. If you have to send money, you can also use this send money option. Payment receive also, and also have the option to mention the vendor destination account. And here you can mention the amount as well as the journal. So it is the basic payment method that you will be seeing. And if you already the payments are made upon, you can see those payments from here. Then we are having the option called as follow-up reports. So basically with this follow-up reports, we can say that here we are having the follow-up reports. So in configuration, if you are seeing, we will be having this follow-up level. So as you, so we can say that it is very essential, means for a business to collect payments when, collect the payments when they are overdue. So with ODO, it will help you to identify those payments that are late and will allow you to send the appropriate reminders. So for that purpose, basically we are having this option called as payment follow. So here you can see that a certain kinds of reminders that is already created, that is first reminder call is the name that you can provide over here. And here you can mention the due date also. And here you can mention the certain actions that you wanted to provide for this particular follow-up report. That is, you can mention, that is whether if you want to send a mail or print a letter, you can use this option over here. So basically what happens is that below that particular due amount, what happens is that automatically a mail would be sending to that corresponding customer, notifying them about the payment, that the payment is not yet done. So we are using this follow-up methods, or you can create the new methods from here also. Here you will have the options to do that also. And in this follow-up reports, what happens is that you will able to see those follow-ups with the status. So here you can see you will have the option to see those invoices who are coming under the basic follow-ups that we have created. That is, to this particular amount it is not, or to this particular invoice it is not yet paid, and the first remainder email is the follow-up that is provided to us, and it will show that is the action is needed for that. So for that, what you can send is that you can have an option to send an email to this particular customer, DecoEdit, in notifying him about this request, that for these invoices he has not yet paid. So either he can do send an email, print a letter, or send by post and remind him also. So for this, we are having this option called as follow-up, which is used to help the customers to provide them or set them a certain kinds of reminders. For that, we are having these options in the follow-ups. Then we are having the product as well as the customers, where you can see all your related products as well as customers that we have discussed in case of the sales and purchase module. So here also we are having that the same thing. And with bills also, I mean with the vendor option also, we are having the bills, refund, payment, product, vendors. So basically it is the same thing with when dealing with purchase, we will be having the options to create the bill. So here you can simply create the bill. You can add the invoice line and all, and also have the options to refund also. So you can also refund from here also. You can create the refund options. So basically, as we are having this credit note in case of sales or in case of customers, here with case of purchase, we are having the option, the credit note, the name changed as refund. So that is only the thing that we are having over here. Then with the product as well as the vendor, we are having the same thing that we have discussed as case of sales and purchase. Then we are having this accounting menu. So under accounting menu, we are having this option called as journal entries. So basically, we can say the journal is a record for all the transactions of a company. That is, in order by date, all the accounting transactions are recorded through the journal entries. We can say like that. So in journal entries, or every financial documents of the companies like bill, invoices, etc. are recorded on the journal entries. So here you would be able to see those entries. So when you remove this miscellaneous itself, you will be seeing those entries. Here you can see the different journals. And from this configuration, you would be having the options to create the journal. So here you can see the created journal over here. You can create a new journal from here. So while creating the journal, here you can provide the name for the journal that would be shown. And here itself, we are having the different types with journals. That is the sales, purchase, cash, bank, and miscellaneous. So sales means it post sent customer invoices. So if the type is sales, we can say that it posts the sent customer invoices. Then the purchase type will post the received vendor bills. Then we are having this cash type, means where you keep a track of petty cash and then daily cash transaction as well as the received customer payment and all. So that type would be coming as the cash. Then we have the type as bank, so which is used to post your bank statement and track this customer payment, vendor payment and all other transactions. We can say that recorded by the associate bank accounts. For that, we are having this type called as bank. And then we are having this miscellaneous. So to post the miscellaneous entries, that is, this journal is basically used for anything that does not fit into this above journal type. So for that, we are having this miscellaneous one. And here you can also provide the certain short code for the journal type also you are creating. And here you will have the other settings for the journal. So from here, what you can do, that is from the configuration, you can create the different journals from this option called as journals. So here you can see the different journals, journal entries, their code and all. So from here you can see the journal entries of that, and here you can see the journal entries for different, that is the for under sales journals, you can see all the invoices that are, means here we have put out the filter based upon the posted one. So you can see all those journals for the sales, and similarly for the purchase also. So here you can see the journal entries for this one that is coming under the purchase and bank and cash also. And similarly with the miscellaneous one also, you would be able to see that options. Then we are having the option called as general ledger. So general ledger, basically we can say it shows all the transactions that happens in your organization. So here you can see we have filtered out based upon the account and posted one. So if you remove that, you can see we will be able to see all the transaction in your organization. So to view that, basically for viewing that, we are having this option called as general ledger over here. And then other option that we are having is with the partner ledger. So basically the partner ledger, in partner ledger, you can see, means with partner ledger, it shows the current open balance with your customer or vendors. So those details you would be getting from this partner ledger option. So basically from here, you would be able to see, means you would be able to see based upon the customer. So it will show the current open balance with your customer or vendor. So for that purpose, we are having the option called as partner ledger in the accounting. Then we are having the option called as automatic transfer. So basically this automatic transfer functionality is used to transfer an amount from one account to another account. So here you can see you will have an option to mention this origin account as well as the transfer account, where you can mention, means here you can mention a certain periodicity, means after this year, this much amount from this account or this much percent of this account should be transferred to another account. So for this purpose, we are having this functionality called as automatic transfer, which will allow you to transfer a certain amount from one account to another account based upon a certain percentage. And here you can see we have the different frequencies, that is on monthly, quarterly and yearly basis. We have a certain kind of period also where we can mention a kind of transfer, internal transfer from one account to another account. So for that we are using this automatic transfer functionality in our accounting module. And then comes this asset management. So basically with asset management, we can say it is a systematic process to organize or monitor, or we can say that to sell the asset of your organization in a cost effective way. So with ODO 14, we can say that it also provides a feature of asset model. So here in this configuration, you will see the option called as asset model. So asset model and asset creation to manage this asset for a company, we are having this option. So a single asset model can be used for creating multiple asset, we can say. So here you can see I have already created one asset model. So create, so in order to create an asset model, here you can mention the name. And here you can mention the different method, that is straight line, degressive, accelerated degressive. So basically this straight line, this will calculate the, we can say that the depreciation linearly, that is equally split for each year if the method is straight line. And then we have this degressive. So for this type of depreciation, the actual amount will be multiplied with the degressive factor that we are mentioning over here, which is the degressible amount. And then we have this accelerated degressive. So it, we can say it is, would be a combination of the straight line as well as the degressive degressive depreciation from the start. So the depreciation would be calculated by multiplying with a factor as the same as the degressive, and when it reaches the linear value, it will automatically follow the straight line method. So that is, then we are having the options to duration, that is number of depreciation needed for this asset. And then also we are having an option called as pro rata temporis. So basically this is the feature to determine from which date the depreciation need to be calculated. And if we check that the first date of depreciation start from the asset creation date would be mentioned over here. And here we are having certain options to mention the fixed asset account and all. So this account will have, which was used, you will use the document that purchasing of that asset at its original cost and all. So here you will have the account details. And then depreciation account will be the account which is used to record the depreciation entries and all. So here you will have those certain informations while creating this asset model and all. So already I have created one model, asset model for laptop. And what I can do is that then I can go to this asset management. So once this information or an asset model is created, make sure that you set this automated asset option to create and validate also. That is here, that is for fixed asset, you will see an option that is automated asset create and validate. So make sure you do that also. Then what you can do is that you can make a purchase of a product and convert that asset using that asset model. So what you can do is that then you can make a purchase of that particular product. So you will have that options to make. So let's say if I have made a purchase also, I can make a purchase of that product and it would be showing a certain kind of options over there. So here I would create, if I then I can, what I can do is that I can create a purchase order and there I can mention the fixed asset account. So when I do so, what happens is that I will get this details where I would be automatically showing, means the depreciation board as well as the related purchase things. So if I do so, I will be getting these options where the original value as well as the acquisition value and other details would be straight coming up. And if I, since I have chosen the method as straight line, it would be showing like this. And here you can see zero post entries, all of them would be in the draft state. And when I enable this only, or when I post them only, it would be changing into the posted state. So what happens is that So from this you can create what happens. So in this way you can manage this. So when you click on this posted, it would be in the posted state. So this is how we can say that you can manage this asset management. So after creating an asset model, what you can do is that you can create a purchase product and can be converted to asset by using this asset model. So for those, create a purchase invoice from accounting module and then add those asset accounting. So suppose I think for in the bill itself, I would be created. Yeah, you can see that I have already created one mentioning that, and I have mentioned the account and particular asset also I would be showing. And its status would be in the running state since I have not posted any of them. So this is how the asset management goes with this. And then we are having this deferred revenue and deferred expense option. So basically with deferred revenue and deferred expense also, we are having the options to create the deferred revenue model as well as the expense model. So with deferred revenue, we can say that it is the money that is received in advance. So here, the status of the money is received, but it is not yet earned. So it is, since it is not yet the income or the revenue, and thus it is needed not, it, so it won't be reported in the income account. So it is rather imported would be as a liability. So for that, we are having this deferred revenue. For that also, we are having the options to create the model also, or otherwise you will have the options here to create this. For example, that here I have already created one where suppose if I want to sell a 5-month service contract for rupees 5,000, that is starting from next month and its duration is that is 5 months. So when you validate the invoice, the amount is 5 months. Five means it would be 5,000 in the report in the deferred revenue account. So when it is so it is received, but it is not earned. So for the next month onwards, you will be reducing 1,000 rupees each for 5 months eventually. So you will be receiving 5,000 at the end of the 5 months. So what happens is that, so for this, you have this deferred revenue model. So you can create the deferred revenue model, or you can do this also. So if I confirm this and compute the revenue, you would be able to see here. That here you can see for 5 months, you would be able to see this one. So here you can see the deferred revenue is computed. That is the revenue 1,000 rupees for each month. So when you post this entries, you can find that these revenue, or you can find that the revenue account to be created, or here you created, so would be debited also. So here you can see, when you compute that, here the zero post entries they would be showing you. So once you post that only, it would be becoming your income, or otherwise it would be still reported as your liability. So for that, we are having this deferred revenue option, and then we are having this deferred expense also. So as a deferred revenue, deferred expense is also, we can say, is the cost that have already occurred for an unconsumed product or the service which is yet to be received. So for that, we are creating this deferred expense. So similarly, we are having this deferred expense model also over creating this deferred expense also. So we assert that is the cost that have already occurred for unconsumed product or service which is not yet received. So such cost, we can say, are the asset for the company. So that pays them, since it is already paid for the product and the services still to receive, or that product are yet to be used. So for that purpose, we are having this deferred expense options over here. So for this also, we are having this options to create the deferred expense model. Similarly, with the deferred revenue also, we are having this deferred revenue model that is in the configuration. And then we are having the options for reconciliation. So basically, we know that the reconciliation is a process of matching the cash account informations of an individual with the details in the bank. So we can say that the main need is to compare them both and check if there is any kind of difference between both of them. So one of the method you can reconcile is from here. You can use these options for the reconciliation. That is, one method is to make a bank payment, and another one is from the dashboard. From the dashboard, here you will have the options to create the statement and then reconcile. Or other option is to make a bank payment. So basically, when you make a bank payment, what happens is that the amount, when you make the payment and all, and the last you will see a green icon, and on clicking on that, it will provide a payment details which is reconciled automatically. Or otherwise, you can do it from here also. That is, from here you can create a bank statement and you can reconcile it. For reconciliation, we can having this two option. That is, the process of matching the cash account informations of an individual with the details of the bank. So for that purpose, we are having this option called as reconciliation. And then we are having this lock date options. So with reconciliation also, we are having the option called as reconciliation model 2. So that we are having in the configuration. So basically, this reconciliation model is to make sure or to ease the speed of reconciliation process. We are using this reconciliation model. So here also we are having the different types, like manually create a write-off and click button, then suggest counterpart value and all. So basically, using these options, you can make, you can easily speed up the reconciliation process. So for that process only, we are making this reconciliation model over here. So for that purpose, we are having this reconciliation model, and then we are having the option called as lock date and all. So with lock date, we are having, means we can mention, so the last date of the financial year that we are closing, you can basically, the lock date is defining that. So here itself, you are having the options to mention the lock date for non-advisor, then lock date for all users and tax lock date and all. So this lock date for non-advisor, here only the users, that is, here only the users with the advisor role can edit the account, which is prior to and inclusive of this date. So here you can mention the date for those. Then you have this lock date for your users, where no users including the advisors can edit the accounts, which is prior to as well as the inclusive of the date you are providing over here. Then you have the tax lock date. So in tax lock date, no user can edit the journal entries related to the tax, that is prior to or inclusive to the amount or the date that you are providing over here. So basically, you can mention the certain lock date and can mention the access to certain kinds of users by setting the dates over here. And then you have the reporting section. So with Odoo Enterprise, you have Odoo Enterprise according section, you have a wide variety, or you have a lot of informations with the reporting sections, like with the balance sheet where it will shows a snapshot of the asset liabilities as well as the equity of your organization. At a particular date also, you would be able to see those options. And you also have a wide options for this profit and losses also, chart of accounts, cash flow statement, partner ledger and options also. Then you also have the options to see this age receivable, age payable. So basically, age payable detailed report, we can say, is to display the informations on individual bill, credit note and overpayment owned by you. So those informations you will be getting in age payable, and then age receivable also. Those reports shows the sales invoices that are awaiting payment during a selected month or a several month prior. You will have this option. Then you also have this tax report and all. So these reports allow you to see the net tax as well as tax amount of all the tax groups by different types. So you will be able to see those. So with reporting of accounting, you will have the different options over here that you can see the different sets of reporting sections. And then here in the configuration, we are having the option called as payment term. So basically, as I told you, that payment terms, we can say, is a payment term regroups all the conditions that comes under with a sale, which makes sure that a sale is completed and paid. So for that, we are having this payment term. So they can be applied to any sale order, customer invoice, or the supplier bills mostly used to ensure that they will be correctly paid. So make from doing that, they are using this option called as payment term. So here itself you will see like 15 days. So here you can see with this also due type also here we will be having this option balance percentage and fixed amount. So here since it is 15 days, so here the full payment would be due for 15 days. So after the invoice date. So for that purpose, we are having these options like the payment terms to create upon. And suppose if I'm saying that is 50% now and the balance in 10 days. So what I can do is that here I can add a percent and I can mention the value 50%. That is 50% now and the balance in 10 days. So the balance I can mention here the due as 10 days. So likewise, you can create the payment terms, which always make sure to make sure that your customer invoice or the vendor bills are completed, paid or not. So for that purpose, we are having this payment terms over here. And then we are having the options to add an account also and add a bank account. You will have the options to add a bank account from here. So already you will see the already created one, or you can create a new one over here from where you can mention the account number, bank, as well as the bank identifier code. And then you are having the chart of accounts details and all. So basically we know that chart of account is a list of all the accounts that is used to record the financial transaction in general ledger of your organization. So here, from here you can create the chart of accounts. So with chart of accounts, you will be having the options to mention the code, account name and the different types. So here you will be seeing the different types that we are having with the chart of accounts also, and also have the options to allow the reconciliation. And when you take the setup also, you will have the certain informations that is related to chart of accounts, like you will have the options like account group. So basically these groups are useful to list the multiple accounts as sub accounts of a bigger account. So for that we are having the option called as groups. Then we are having the option called as tag. That is some accounting reports require tag to set that, as I told you, a certain kind of label on a relevant account. So for that we can use that. And then you can see we have certain automated deferred expenses over here. That is no create draft and create and validate. So this, if it is no, this is a default value. So when it is create in draft, so whenever a transaction is posted on the account, a draft entry would be created, but it won't be validated. But in this case, it would be validated. So these options we are having over here. And here we are having the options mentioning the deprecated. So here we have a boolean field over here. So basically with Odoo, it is not possible to delete an account once a transaction has been recorded on it. So one can make them as unstable by using this deprecated feature. So for that we are having the deprecated option over here. So these are the options that we are getting with chart of accounts, the different types and all. And then the main thing that we are going with is define the physical position. So basically this physical position, as I have told you, that we can say that physical position, here you can see we have already created. So we know that, as we know, for every state or every country the taxes are different. So while doing the purchase or the sales, there would be the changes in the currency values as well as the tax rate. So in order to measure that, we are having the option called as physical position. So basically here you can mention the name. So let me show you the already created one. So here you can mention the physical position. So here you can mention the name and company also. And here with physical position, it helps you to provide a tax mapping as well as the account mapping functionality. So suppose here if I mention that is tax on report, sorry, tax on product. So here the tax on product is the default taxes that would be applied to a particular product. And here the tax to apply shows the tax that we want to apply on a certain product. Here you can mention that, and similarly you can do that with the account mapping. So what happens is that suppose if I create this physical position and save this, and for my particular customer, if I mention this as a particular if I mention this physical position as Dubai for my particular customers, that is for my decorative, if I'm mentioning this physical product, what happens is that for that product, since I have applied, that is 15% tax on product should be applied on to 5%. So here you can see for this product, I have, that is a tax on product is 15%, and here the tax to apply is 5%. So automatically what happens is that if I make an order for my particular product and if I select my particular customer as Deco Edit, you can see. So if I selected my customer as Deco Edit and if I selected the product called as acoustic block screen, and for this acoustic block screen, make sure here you provide the customer tax also. So let me say this. So you here you can see when I selected that customer, automatically the tax get mapped to 5%, whereas the customer tax was 15%, but here it maps to 5%. So this is the use of the physical position that we are using, that is the tax mapping. So here the tax is correspondingly mapped, 15% tax is correspondingly mapped to 5%. So correspondingly, you can also do with the account also. So for that purpose, we are having this option called as physical position option. And then we are having an option for payment request. So basically, Odoo embeds a several payment methods that allows your customer to pay, pay on their customer portal as well as your e-commerce website and all. So using this payment request, it will allow you to pay your sale order invoices and so on with their favorite payment request. So here you will have the options to create those payment requests. So here you can see the already created payment request. So it will help the customers to use this payment request, which is including both the online payment as well as which helps the providers to accept the credit card also. So those options are also over here. Here you can see the some of the online credit card method also. You can install that also. So for that purpose, we are having this payment request. So you can create the payment request as per your need also. So this is some of the functionalities that we are having with our accounting module. And as we have discussed that we have seen a wide options for reporting for accounting module itself. So these are some of the functionalities we can say. This is the complete overview that I can provide you with the sales purchase as well as the accounting module. So this is in nutshell, we can say we have seen the overview with all the functionalities that we are having with the case of purchase, accounting, as well as the sales module. So as we have seen all these details, so if you have any kind of inquiries or any questions, just drop your message to odoo.cybrosis.com, and you can also view our blogs also at www.cybrosis.com. You can view our blogs also, and you can also visit to our YouTube channel where you can see here we have provided the link, so you can also view this. So if you have any inquiries, please drop your request to odoo.cybrosis.com. So thank you all for attending this session and wishing you a nice day. Thank you.